first and 10, wants it all. Deep over the middle for Winicky, has it inside the 10.
Still with it, Diana Powerhouse!
Ilfil Velez on the run, diving in the alley.
It's Alexander with a nice move, goes to the rim, got it to go!
Hi, friends, and welcome inside our Jaeger Media Center studios and the Jackrabbit Insider. I'm Tyler Merriam. Delighted you could join us this week. The SDSU football team vying for a Missouri Valley Football Conference championship on Saturday at Northern Iowa. The highlights, Coach John Stiglmeyer in studio, and a look at the upcoming FCS playoffs. It's all right around the corner. Plus, our final senior student athlete spotlight from the football program. We'll talk to offensive lineman Nick Carr a little bit later. But this season, for the SDSU soccer team, a third consecutive Summit League championship and third straight trip to the NCAA College Cup. And to recap the year, we sat down with head coach Lang Wiedemeyer.
And when you lose nine seniors, your whole back line, I think 85% of your scoring, there are a lot of question marks coming into a season. I think that our players really stepped up.
Wiedemeyer rotated two goalkeepers throughout the year. Senior Nicole Inskeep, a two-time All-Conference selection, and Sioux Falls native Maggie Smither, a redshirt freshman. Each played significant time in the box, and both performed well, making the coach's job difficult.
Nikki certainly has been a goalkeeper that's won us a couple championships in the past, and she picked up right where she left off and was doing very well. Maggie is a redshirt freshman, really kind of came into her own, started growing confidence, they were playing so well, we had to split them the whole season. And when it was Maggie's turn to step up, when Nikki went down with an injury in the semifinal game of the conference tournament, Maggie was ready to go.
The Jacks certainly had a flair for the dramatic. In the Summit League semifinals, they trailed 1-0 to Denver before scoring in the 76th minute to tie the game. It went into a shootout after two scoreless overtimes, and the Jacks won that 4-2 to move on to the championship. Vying for the title against Oral Roberts, neither team scored through regulation or overtime, necessitating another shootout. Again, the Jacks proved victorious 3-2 to claim their third consecutive Summit League championship. And in the opening round of the NCAA College Cup, SDSU fought tooth and nail with Nebraska, and again, the game was scoreless through two overtimes. But this time, the squad came up short in the shootout, seeing their season come to an end.
We played exceptionally well, one of the best games of the season. Nebraska's incredibly athletic, very difficult team to play against, plays a formation we hadn't seen all season. You know, we're playing a team that was fresh, hungry, motivated, and certainly we rose to the occasion, I thought. I thought we played toe-to-toe with them through the first half and good portions of the second half. We had our chances to score. We had opportunities to win the game. But I thought our team played really, really well, played with a lot of heart.
The Jacks had six players recognized by the Summit League. First-teamers Tori Poole and Nicole Hatcher return next year, as do all freshman selections Maggie Smither and Alexa Heppner. So while there's reason for optimism that the Jacks will shoot for a fourth straight Summit League title in 2017, Wiedemeyer admits there's also a bit of wonder. What if?
Well, we told the team afterward, you live by the sword, you die by the sword. I mean, you know, you can only go to the well so many times, and I think that it was just difficult for us going into it. In one regard, I felt like we had just been there twice. We had confidence. We knew the routine. But at the same time, you know, it takes some luck, and we just kind of ran out of it at that point.
A terrific run of success recently for Lang Wiedemeyer and Jackrabbit soccer. We'll talk to head coach John Stiglmeyer from the SDSU football team and recap Saturday's season finale at Northern Iowa after you go on a trip inside state.
Thanks to SDSU, I'm ready to take on the world. I think I'm ready to go out into the world of pharmacy and make an impact and help change lives. My name's Christian Kroll, and I'm originally from Orinoco, Minnesota, which is right north of Rochester, Minnesota. I've got to kind of expand and look and say, oh, there's a lot more to pharmacy than just this. So definitely giving me more options and more ideas of what I could do for the rest of my life. I love the Honors Hall personally. I got to live there for 2 years, and I love the style of rooms that they have. I love the community that you build there. Our honors classes are a great deal. No matter what class you go into, they're gonna be smaller, and you get priority registration, which is nice as well. I still have connections from the professors in my honors courses to this day for my freshman year. So I've been a big part of intramurals. I've done volleyball and basketball and basically everything. And I've also been a big part of the tutoring program. That's been my big one. So I've been a tutor for the chemistry programs, anatomy, and pathophysiology program. SDSU is a place where you can be a part of a lot of things and still enjoy your time here. Whereas some bigger schools, you might only be able to join one club or organization. SDSU, you can be in a lot of different things and enjoy it at the same time. I have a lot of time left, but I'd like to go maybe a clinical or hospital route, something along those lines, just continuing my education. I definitely want to stay in the Midwest. I like the community here, and it's home for me. They're definitely giving me the leadership skills, the communication skills, and just basically being able to be personable with people.
Down to a minute 25 and ticking. Walker back to throw, throws it right side, going to be intercepted! It was picked off at the 38-yard line by the Jackrabbits. They've got the football.
Brock Gentile.
Listen up. This is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
How did we become the region's largest independent seed company? By taking a very simple but powerful stand. We will sell no seed that we wouldn't be happy to plant on our own farm. Peterson Farm Seed. Stand tall.
Being part of a great team means you know your role and you work your role to the best of your ability. If you're consistently going to show up and be your best, you're going to be part of that team. You can see the success they have over time. It's not just 1 year flash in the pan. It's consistent success over time, which makes them great. And that's where the work ethic comes in. The ability to come into work, do the same thing repeatedly, day after day after day, and putting your best foot forward is going to separate you from the rest.
Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
This portion of the Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it.
Welcome back to the Insider. This man needs no introduction. The head football coach at South Dakota State, John Stiglmeyer. Missouri Valley Football Conference champions. Has quite a ring to it.
Well, it feels good. It feels good for this football team. I hope it feels good for everybody that played for the Jackrabbits. We got a big family, and the bar keeps being raised, and they're all part of it. But right now, we feel special.
How did the shower feel right after the game?
That did not feel good. That caught me off guard, but I guess that's tradition, so we'll go with the tradition.
The Jacks are conference champions and a top eight seed in the FCS playoffs after the win on Saturday at Northern Iowa. Let's jump right into it. South Dakota State on the third play of the game. Taryn Christian connects with Jake Winicky on a 30-yard score. 7-0 Jacks. UNI just over 3 minutes later responds. Jalen Rima, the reception from Eli Dunn. The wide receiver takes it 36 yards to tie the game at 7. SDSU would go 67 yards and 6 plays on the ensuing drive. Christian this time on the receiving end of a Jake Winicky pass. The trickery leads to a 14-7 SDSU lead. UNI returns the ensuing kickoff for a score. It's 14-14 midway through the first. It stayed that way until early in the second. What a catch by Winicky. A 5-yarder from Christian. Jacks lead at 21-14 at that point. It was 21-17 at the half. Taryn Christian, an 11-yard touchdown run, made it 28-17. UNI responds with a Javion Browning 1-yard touchdown run late in the third. The Jacks come back in the fourth. Kyle Paris a 3-yard run to make it 35-24. Chase Vinatieri tacks on a field goal with 5:27 left. The Jacks lead 38-24, and UNI running out of time with just under 90 seconds left. Eli Dunn is drilled by Dallas Brown. The ball pops into the air, and Yankton native Kellen Solick rumbles down the sideline for a 65-yard pick six, and South Dakota State wins 45-24. In a game like this, turnovers usually play a big role. You forced four of them. two in the red zone. A couple of times you and I had chances to take the lead in this game, and you turned them back. Obviously, the final turnover is what sealed the deal. But four turnovers forced against a team that was one of the best in the country in turnover margin was a decisive factor on Saturday.
There were a number of huge plays in the game, but you know, in the game of football, a turnover always should be huge. And we made some great plays down by the goal line, but again, we made some great plays. It wasn't necessarily their miscue. We're really excited about that.
Because of those turnovers, you and I never led in this game, and again, from a momentum standpoint, that was big.
It was big because they're at home. They have their crowd. Their crowd would get into it, affect the game a little bit, and then sit back down. And so I thought our team did a good job of, and we've talked about that, about controlling the environment.
Halfway through the first quarter, there's already four touchdowns on the board. This thing started in a word that you hate using, shootout.
Yeah, I don't like that. I mean, we scored three plays, boom, boom, boom. And I the first thing I say to our offensive staff is, you know, make sure they understand that's not the real world. They go down and score, we score, the kickoff return. That should not have happened. You know, and I credit that kid for being fast, but that should not have happened.
Mark Farley, teams that you and I typically are good defensively and typically run the football very well. You held you and I to 56 rushing yards, 118 below their season average on the ground.
Huge factor in the game, made them you know, one-dimensional. In fact, I said to the defensive staff at one point, they can't run the football. To get back in the game, they can't run the football. And a credit to our scheme, but a credit to those four guys and our linebackers, safeties filling, a phenomenal job of dominating the line of scrimmage.
Defense played well, and you mentioned that kick return that shouldn't have happened for a touchdown. Other than that, Sam Coob, the placement of his kicks, it's maybe the most boring highlight package we show ever because it's a bunch of fair catches on kicks, but Coob did an excellent job for you and even kicked one deep later in the game to catch them off guard.
You know, we tell everybody when you're on the field, play like it's your last play, and who knows, that play may impact the game, may win the game. And as boring as it seems, lobbing the kick, we saw the alternative when they returned one. So I love Sam Coob, and I love what he was able to do in the game.
Well, Taron Christian certainly is not boring. 21 of 27, 272 yards. He threw for two touchdowns. He rushed for a touchdown. He even caught a touchdown pass on Saturday. Quite a day for the sophomore QB.
I would say we got our money's worth out of his scholarship. Phenomenal job of running the show. A lot of those passes were run pass options, so just a really special job. There's some pressure in that situation. Ran the ball well, had the one fumble, but he's trying to get some extra yards. And then to see him catch the trick play, you know, from Jake, that was neat.
And we mentioned Jake Whitaker, seven catches for 136, two touchdowns receiving. He also threw that touchdown pass to Taron Christian. You had said before the game, we're going to throw more than we have the past couple of weeks, and Whitaker rose to the occasion.
Well, we needed to. I mean, they're a physical defense, and what we did against their defense, I think, is pretty special because they are a good defense. I thought Jake came to the game. I could see it in his eyes. He came to the game and said internally, you know, I'm going to play like it's my last play. He had a phenomenal game.
Dallas Brown had a big day defensively. Seven tackles. He had a sack. He broke up a pass with a deflection as he was blitzing. He forced a fumble. He comes up with an interception. I mean, he was involved in two of the four turnovers. A huge day for your senior linebacker.
Great, great day. I mean, and again, these guys, those guys that are seniors, they're thinking one more game maybe. And so credit to him raising his level. The interception on the goal line was a phenomenal play. And I wish he had laid down, taken a knee, but he wanted to take it the whole way. But played like it was last play all the time.
Speaking of guys taking it all the way, we'd be remiss if we didn't revisit Kellen Solik's game-winning interception return for the touchdown. What a race between him and offensive lineman Cal Twait to the end zone it was at the end.
Well, it was an exciting play. It's going to make a great memory for anybody that observed that, that was there. You know, obviously our fans and our players. Really a special way to end that football game, and really put it away, I guess.
We talked about Missouri Valley Football Conference Championship earlier, but top eight seed, it also means a home game in the playoffs, so you get this weekend off, then you're home next weekend. What does that mean to your program?
Well, it means we better use it. We better take care of ourselves. We got to get rested up. We've got a lot of guys we've talked about who have been beat up. This first week, we're going to be kind of all fundamental type stuff. Let them off for Thanksgiving. We're going to have Thanksgiving on Tuesday night as a football team. And then ideally, we'll get a jump on game planning. But we just, you know, we're in a foreign territory, a different situation. But I think we've got a good game plan for it.
You'll play the winner of St. Francis and Villanova in 13 days' time. But I think at this this point, you don't really care who you play, do you?
We don't care. We're excited to get the top eight seed. You know, that we keep trying to find ways to take steps forward. Obviously, winning the conference championship is a big deal, first one in a while, and then to be a top eight seed nationally, that says something about Jackrabbit football.
Coach, congratulations.
Thanks, Tyler.
John Stiglmeyer, head coach of the Jackrabbits. We'll have a closer look at the FCS playoffs in just a moment, but first up, this week's Jackrabbit legend.
From a town of 200 people in southern Minnesota to Division II's leading rusher, this week's Jackrabbit legend is Dan Sonic, presented by Legend Seeds. Most people associate 1980s SDSU football with the aerial assault, but that's forgetting one of the greatest running backs to sport the yellow and blue. Playing alongside quarterbacks Mike Bush and Ted Wall, and receivers Jeff Tiefenthaler and Dennis Thomas, Sonic created quite a niche for himself, earning the nickname Super Sonic along the way. In his first career start, the opening game of his sophomore year, he rushed 21 times for 123 yards. Later, during the 1985 season, he set a single-game rushing mark with 266 yards against Augustana. 3 weeks later, Sonic passed that, rushing for 268 against Northern Colorado. Those outbursts ranked third and fourth in school history, as the 200-pound tailback set a then-school record for rushing in a season, 1,518 yards, led all of Division II in the process. 18 times during his career, he posted 100 or more rushing yards. He also led the team in receptions as a senior, hauling in 80 passes, covering some 800 yards for the duration of his career. A three-year starter who earned the title of All-American in 1987, he ranks fourth in school history for career rushing yards, 3,304. Dan Sonic, Jackrabbit legend. This Jackrabbit legend is presented by Legend Seeds, your regional seed leader.
Being part of a great team means you know your role and you work your role to the best of your ability. If you're consistently going to show up and be your best, you're going to be part of that team. You can see the success they have over time. It's not just 1 year flash in the pan. It's consistent success over time, which makes them great. And that's where the work ethic comes in. The ability to come into work, do the same thing repeatedly, day after day after day, and putting your best foot forward is going to separate you from the rest.
Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
Get ready for the Hefties Fan PhD Tip of the Week, encouraging you to get up, get loud, and get involved, and give the Jackrabbits a hometown advantage.
This year was fantastic. I got my best yields ever.
Record yields start by putting the best seed in the ground. At Hefty, we not only pick the best genetics and traits for you, but we have the most stringent seed grower specs in the industry. That means higher yields for you.
We're Hefties! And we're big on the farm.
Hefty brand soybeans. Agronomy answers yield.
Hey, Jacks fans. We love to have you at the game. We love your involvement. Again, make sure you're positive. Not everybody at the game is an SDSU alum, and so this is our chance to sell who we are and what we're about, so be positive.
This week's fan tip was brought to you by Hefty's Fan PhD, helping Jackrabbit fans go from good to great. Before we get back to this week's show, here's a look at next week's Insider. Welcome back to the Insider. We already talked to football coach John Stiglmeyer, the South Dakota State Jackrabbits, the number eight seed in the FCS playoffs. That means they not only receive an opening round bye, but they will have a home game a week from Saturday, December the 3rd, at Dana J. Dykal Stadium. Let's take a closer look at the brackets and who the Jacks might play in 13 days. Again, the Jackrabbits will be at home on December 3rd at 2 o'clock Central Time at Dana J. Dykal Stadium against the winner of Saturday's opening round contest featuring St. Francis of Pennsylvania and Villanova. That game will take place Saturday afternoon at 1 o'clock Central. ESPN3 is the place to see this game and all of the FCS playoffs. Let's take a closer look at both of these schools. St. Francis of Pennsylvania, the Red Flash, Northeastern Conference champions. They played 7 road games this season out of their 11. They won 3 on the road, all 4 at home. With a 7-4 record, they enter the postseason. They are led by Cameron Lewis. We talk about Jake Winicky. Lewis is just as talented. He leads the nation in receiving yards with 1,349. But St. Francis is also very good defensively. They are allowing less than 19 points a game, 10th best scoring defense in the FCS, and they're averaging almost 3.5 sacks per game, which ranks second in the country. On the flip side, Villanova comes out of the CAA, led by 37th-year head coach Andy Talley. He has already announced he is retiring after this season. Villanova's three losses are to playoff teams James Madison and Richmond, and then to FBS Pittsburgh. They do have a win over a playoff team in Lehigh. Villanova is built on defense. The Wildcats are allowing just 15 points a game. That's third best in the country. And their total defense, just 265 yards per game, is also third best in the FCS. And Villanova has a pretty good rush game as well, scoring 212 yards per game on the ground, which ranks them on the top 20 in the country. So again, Villanova will host St. Francis of Pennsylvania at 1 o'clock Central Time this coming Saturday. The winner of that game will face the 8th-seeded Jackrabbits on Saturday, December the 3rd at 2 o'clock Central Time. And then looking forward, the 8th-seeded Jackrabbits are matched up with top seed North Dakota State. If both were to win, SDSU would go to Fargo the second weekend in December. And of course, the Jackrabbits handed NDSU its only loss of the regular season. So that's where things sit as we look forward in the FCS playoffs.
So the Jackrabbit football team will host a second round playoff game on Saturday, December the 3rd, 2 o'clock Central Time, the kickoff at Dana J. Dykhouse Stadium. More coming up on The Insider after this week's Jackrabbit Hot Seat.
Hi, my name is Sydney Rasmussen. I'm from Melrose, Minnesota. I'm majoring in apparel merchandising and I'm on the swim team. My favorite TV show would have to be Hawaii Five-O because I really like Hawaii and the comedy is there with also the crime fighting. My favorite food would have to be spaghetti because I really like noodles and I don't really like meat that much. So there's no meat in the sauce. The reason I swim is because of my parents, I would say. Both of them were college swimmers, and my older sister just went through college swimming, and my younger sister is looking forward to college swimming. So it's kind of just in our family, and it's something that we kind of all have together as a bond. I would say the best part of Brookings is the small town feel, even though it's not that small. The community is very nice and friendly, and it kind of makes it seem like it's home, even though we're away from home. The reason I chose SDSU was the campus feel was very positive and welcoming and it just felt right.
To me, sustainability means being able to feed the world in the future.
We need to produce more with less.
It's knowing that our soil is going to be in better shape this year than it was the year before.
We need to stop erosion at the top of the hill, not at the bottom.
We find that we can merge sustainable practices with profitability.
It's about caring for the land.
It's about passing it on to the next generation.
It's about doing the right thing. I have a responsibility
for the people of South Dakota
to feed the world.
The future of farming is very bright.
I'm Jeff Lochner.
Steve Halverson.
Al Miron.
This is farming.
Listen up. This is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
We'll be right back.
The Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by the Hefty Seed Company, Agronomy, Answers, Yield. Your local Northland Ford dealers. Visit northlandford.com or your local dealer. Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it. The University Bookstore. Shop now at jackrabbitcentral.com. South Dakota Corn. This is Farming. Proud sponsor of the South Dakota Showdown Series. And by South Dakota State University. Be great. Start here.
Welcome back. The final senior student athlete spotlight from the SDSU football program this season highlights an offensive tackle who has really stepped up this year. Here's a closer look at Nick Carr.
I started in second grade, I think, and even since second grade, I was a little bit bigger than everybody else, so I was an O-lineman then, too.
Carr was all Minnesota at Totino Grace High School in the Twin Cities.
And I was kind of already set on engineering in high school, so when Coach Eric Eisness came and talked to me, one of the first things he said was, we have a great academic school, including engineering, and that piqued my attention right away.
You know, Nick came here wanting to be an engineer, wanting to play a bunch of football. He's going to be an engineer. He's suffered through a bunch of injuries and kind of set him back, but one of the coolest things I've experienced is Dad told me when we honored him at senior day that when we came for the home visit, that was one of the biggest days in Nick's life, meaning this decision to come to South Dakota State has been a tremendous decision.
Stiglmeyer alluded to the injuries. Carr had made 9 starts at left tackle in 2014 and was expected to be a starter when practices began the following spring.
Our first scrimmage, and you know, everything was just kind of going normal. And I think it was pretty early in the scrimmage. I was just blocking a guy over to the left, and all of a sudden I had 2-3 guys fall in the back of my right knee. And then I went in for an MRI, and they told me I tore my ACL.
It set him back. It was his time. But like a lot of winners and like all the guys in our team, he came back. He was a great leader. He knew he had to rehab, do everything he could, and he's done that.
Carr has started every game for the Jacks this season, and as his college career winds down, he can also look forward to graduating with a degree in mechanical engineering.
My passion for engineering, I suppose, would start with physics. I took physics as a freshman in high school and had a very good teacher for that. I never got really big into math. That was just kind of a plus. Once I got into engineering, I got good at math, but it kind of started with physics and being interested in that. I love to fish, so I wouldn't mind getting into a fishing company maybe, but we'll see. We'll see how it goes.
We hope you enjoyed this week's show. On behalf of all of us here in Jackrabbit Athletics and the Yeager Media Center, we wish you a very happy Thanksgiving holiday. We also want to remind you about the SDSU men's basketball team competing in the Sanford Pentagon Showcase. All 4 teams involved, 20 win programs from a year ago. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, the event in Sioux Falls. Call 312-7900 or visit Ticketmaster.com to join us this weekend. FCS playoffs for Jackrabbit football and a lot more in the weeks to come, so we hope you'll join us next time. For all of us here in the Yeager Media Center studios, I'm Tyler Merriam, and we'll see you after Thanksgiving on the Jackrabbit Insider.
South Dakota State has won the Missouri Valley Football Conference Championship for the first time in program history.